Hi everyone, welcome back to Reading Time with Quinn. I'm Quinn and I'm doing a reading, hence the name. Or if it's your first time here, welcome for the first time. I hope you enjoy your experience. Today I am just doing for you all a reading for your October 2019 ahead of you. Sitting here enjoying my pumpkin spice, pretending it's cold outside. Anyway, so here we have Group 1 with green calcite. We have Group 2 with obsidian. We have Group 3 with amethyst, if I can hold it right. And we have Group 4 with this lovely little yellow citrine that matches my shirt. Sort of. Okay, so take a moment to find your center, pause the video if you need to take a few breaths or meditate on the cards, and ask yourself and your intuition which deck or decks are meant for you. As this is a general reading, you might identify with one entire deck or parts of a few or all of a few if you've got a ton going on. But anyway, I'm just going to get into it with pile one right now. So, move these out of the way. For those of you who chose pile one with this lovely green calcite here, I'm going to start with the tarot and then move on to the oracle cards. So we have temperance. Sorry if these get out of the shot. There's a lot of cards. We have the Nine of Feathers. We have the Knight of Crystals. We have the Four of Crystals. We have the Chariot. Seven of Fire. The Ten of Fire. Sorry, I'm covering it. let's put that there. We have the King of Water. Beautiful. We have the Six of Fire. Wonderful. We have the Three of Air. I keep covering up the... whatever. Okay, and then for the oracle cards, we have, for the botanical oracle, we have Elder Ritual. We have Sobriety. Okay. Oof. We have Bridget, Don't Back Down, from the Goddess Oracle. And then we have the Knight, Be Brave and Honest. Ooh, these are just barely fitting, so I'm going to move these up a little bit. Remember that for the rest of the decks. Okay, and then for the Dragon Oracle cards, we have the Lilac Fire Dragon. And we have the Green Gold Dragon from Sirius. Okay. Okay, so starting with the tarot cards, what I'm seeing is that first and foremost, let me clarify that these first three cards, Temperance, Nine of Feathers, and the Knight of Crystals, came out flying, so those really wanted to come out for you. Overall, I'm seeing that coming into October, you might be coming out of something that hits you pretty hard, so hard it might have made you like lose sleep over it, just a lot of anxiety over it. And this October energy is about balance for you, finding balance from that, healing from that, being more grounded in the real world. Honestly, you might be the kind of person who just kind of like floats off into space sometimes and you're just not super grounded in reality. And that's great to be such a creative and emotional soul and a spiritual person, but we are here on Earth and we have to spend some time grounded in reality or else we lose touch with what's actually going on. And that's kind of the energy I'm getting from this deck, or those who chose this stack. I'm seeing that it's time to kind of like put the focus blinders on and like set some goals. Like, yes, you have, I'm seeing you have these like creative aspects. That's what you guys already have. You're good at that. But it's time to like actually make it concrete, make plans and start, like, especially with this Knight of Crystals, actually start taking like physical steps, planning out what you need to do to take all that great creativity you have and to ground it in reality. And with the Four of Crystals, it's funny because like I'm like, oh, this is so me too. With this Four of Crystals here, I'm seeing that you're kind of, you are most likely a person who is like all in or all out. You live in the black and the white. You don't like to live in that gray area, and that's not always great. It's good to be so passionate and to feel so strongly about your decisions, but sometimes life happens in that gray area. And so I'm seeing that the danger for you this October is going completely the opposite direction. Like saying, oh, this thing happened that didn't work out for me, and it was because I was too much of a space head. I was too in my ideas. And you're just going to go completely in the opposite direction with this Four of Crystals. And the danger here is losing that spark, losing that creativity and that passion, and saying, well, that wasn't working out for me, so I'm just going to live completely in the boring material world and just go to my 9-to-5 that I don't like and give up on my dreams. That's not what this is trying to say. It's trying to say, with this Temperance, balance of the two is what is needed for you. I didn't mean to make that sound like Dr. Seuss. Anyway, and so this nice little progression here is this balance. Whether you're someone who has that like fiery passion and needs to ground it, or I'm just because there's so many people, it could be the opposite way. So finding a balance between the two is what's going to bring you to this victory that you've been wanting for a long time. And I think in my last reading, there was a Chariot deck, which also had a lot of similar cards. So it carries through. And this isn't just like a little tiny victory. This is like something you've been like wanting for yourself. You've been wanting that next step and you're like, where is it? Well, the way to get to it for you, at least one of the ways, one of the things you need to get done, is finding this balance between your passion and just making it grounded in reality. Yeah, and so moving on from that, I'm seeing that, lots of things. Okay, so you are overall going to be recognized for your greatness this October. But I'm also seeing that you need to remember to like stick to your morals. This is really funny imagery because with this card, I always think, you know, stay on the high horse. not in a pretentious way, but just like stick to your morals, stick to what you actually believe in. You have to stick that out. I'm seeing this is like a month of patience. Again, back to this Temperance. This is a month for you to be patient with the process and learn how to be really patient, because I'm seeing that for you, you might just not be a very patient person. And I'm seeing that the danger here for you is with taking on too much. Again, with this living in the black and white, you are probably someone who's going to think, well, I need more balance in my life. Okay, let me, all this balance, 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 when really that's not balance, that's going overboard again, just in a completely different direction. And again, I'm laughing because this deck is so mean. Okay, so this is what's going to be important for you this whole month, is to keep checking in with your emotions so that you know that you're not taking on too much. There's this balance between, yes, I'm sticking to what I believe in, I'm sticking to my goals and my beliefs, and staying like way up in the higher vibrations where I belong, but not taking on too much. Like if you, sorry, I keep like throwing these cards in your face, but if you check in with your emotions and it's too much, take a little break. I mean, it's okay to take the easy way sometimes. Like we're humans in human bodies with human emotions, and they're there for a reason. So listen to them. Keep checking in with your emotions so you know you're not taking on too much or too little. Again, balance is the key word for you this month. Not to be negative, but this with this three of air here, which correlates to the usual three of swords, I'm just seeing that the real danger here for you is that if you don't do this, you're going to end up getting hurt again. Like with this nine of feathers that you went through, I'm seeing that it's just going to be history repeating itself. You're going to get hurt again. You're going to go overboard. Then you're going to be disappointed, and something honestly kind of bad might happen. You might just be disappointed that you're not making progress, okay? And that can be heartbreaking when it's over and over again. So moving on to the oracle cards, we have, starting with ritual, in relation to what we've read from the tarot cards, for you, I'm seeing that this is just going to be a daily reminder of yourself, because this is probably a habit that's so ingrained in you. You're going to have to remind yourself every single day, even though it's hard, to keep checking in and make sure you're not just going overboard in one direction or the other. Okay, this makes sense. We have the sobriety card here with the butterfly oracle. So I'm seeing that for some of you, this overboard tendency, which isn't always so pleasant to hear from other people, is that there's just like something in your life that you're kind of addicted to. It might be stress, it might be drugs or alcohol. I won't get too into that, but there's something that you are just using as a coping mechanism. And, you know, sometimes we need a crutch, but it's this fine line, again, keyword, temperance, balance, is that it's just when you cross that line and become dependent that has not been helpful for you. And so we have with Bridget, don't back down. It's just you're going to keep needing to remind yourself throughout the month that you're sticking this out for a reason. You want a better life. You want your dreams and goals to come true. And again, with the knight, be brave and honest. I'm seeing this connected to the King of Water, and there's similar, these really masculine energies, very connected. Just keep being honest with yourself about what you're feeling. If it's too hard, I mean, whatever. If society says you have to get up and be productive every day, even if you feel like dirt, you don't. I mean, maybe you don't get fired from your job, like don't skip work 5 days a week, but this is a month for you to make all these big changes, and that's not easy. So keep checking in with yourself. Listen to what your body and your emotions are telling you. Okay, and then we have this lilac fire dragon. Transmutes through the power of divine love. Open up to transcendent love and enlightenment. Purity of heart brings peace, hope, and joy. And with the green gold dragon from Sirius, I love dragons if you couldn't tell, brings universal knowledge to your spiritual pathway. Learn about spiritual technology, be a transmitter of sacred knowledge. So overall, I'm just seeing that you guys have a lot, you people tuning in, have a lot of gifts to offer this world. And that's the thing to keep in mind, is that you have a lot of wisdom and love coming into you that you need to accept so you can continue giving that out to other people. This motion here, that there's a bigger picture. It's not just, well, how do I get motivated to bring balance in my life just to get a promotion in my job or something like that. It's a bigger picture. It's a bigger picture of creating a better life for yourself so that you can continue accepting those higher vibrational ways of thinking, this divine pure love and this wisdom, and that you can use that to better the condition and the lifestyles and the vibration of everyone here on Earth. Okay, not to end on a huge cosmic note, but that's all I have for group one, so I'm going to move on to group two. As soon as I put the cards away. Alrighty. So, those of you who chose group two with the obsidian, I'm going to start with the tarot and then the oracle. So we have the four of feathers. We have the page of shells. Putting these up higher, like I said I would. We have the star. Woo! We have the eight of feathers. Fun, fun. We have the ten of shells. We have the ten of earth. Okay, October, coming through. We have the three of earth. We have the nine of earth. Okay, earth group. We have the two of air. And we have the queen of water. So already we're seeing some similarities between the last group, if you picked both. And then for the oracle, we have Rowan, protection from the botanicals. I'm literally always covering up the words for those of you who like to see the words. We have end of an era from the butterflies. From the goddess deck, we have Rhiannon, sorceress. About manifestation. We have the spirit fox, trust your talents in changing times. Fun stuff here. Straighten these up. We have the alpha dragon. And we have the fire dragon. Wonderful. Okay. So, starting with the tarot, I'm seeing that overall, which again, this has a lot of similarities between group one already, is that there's, so end goal right here, the star, I just always think of wishing on a star, dreams coming true, but for you this is peace and healing, especially with this four of feathers. This is the time of letting yourself have this rest, and I'm seeing it as emotional rest, physical rest, and also mental rest. I'm seeing that a lot of you, especially with getting into this eight of feathers here, I'm seeing that you have a tendency to just get in your head, and that's holding you back from, and you probably know this is what I'm feeling, is that you know that getting in your head is holding you back from achieving your goals. And from achieving, like, healing, there might be something in your past that you've been trying to heal from, and you just, like, get in your head about it. Like, you maybe tell yourself that you're guilty somehow. Like, you were kind of a victim of something, and then you kind of, like, almost, like, victim shame yourself, and you're, you know, deny yourself that something happened, that someone did something, or that something that just was not good happened. And you just get in your head and tell yourself, it was my fault. And it's exhausting. Like, you see how this bear is just asleep? That needs to be you. You need to sleep. You need to let your mind take a break. Like, you are just, like, not ever giving yourself a break is what I'm feeling. Like, this really good energy from these cards right here. Yeah, and this page of shells here with intuition and inspiration. is that it's just, it's time for you to get a fresh new, like, let your emotions feel renewed. I just, like, felt a sigh of relief holding this card. Is that, like, the release from all this tension for you is to let your mind be at rest so you can feel these new, more positive emotions coming in. Because, and then with this Ten of Shells, just blessings, well-being, overall, just, like, really emotional blessings. Blessings of your emotions, that's what that means, clearly. yeah, I mean, I could keep going on that, but it's pretty straightforward. It's just that you are, even though it's not always fun to hear, like, you're creating these mental blocks for yourself that are in turn just kind of like shutting you down, blocking you off from receiving emotional positivity. You might have noticed, like, repeating negative relationships, the same negative people coming to you. Well, improving these mental blocks is what's going to help you open up to the healing process and thus, like, inviting better situations and better people into your life. I'm saying that that's something that you really want. And on the flip side of that, so this can be something that happens for you pretty quickly in the month. I mean, as soon as you decide to just, like, buckle down and be like, I want this. I'm taking this for myself because I deserve this. You are going to feel so much more stable and secure and more grounded, earth grounded, you get it? like so much more safe and secure, and not just in, like, you know, having a lot of nice things around you, but just feel like your life is more grounded. Like, there's not going to be some metaphorical breeze that's just going to blow your whole life away. And this is going to have something to do with finding a group of people, or, you know, just like one person or something. Maybe it's colleagues, maybe it's friends that you just enjoy being around, and that you, I'm seeing that a lot of you are going to create things with these people. These might be, if you're an artist, just other artists. If you're a musician, other musicians. I'm a musician. And then we have this Nine of Earth too. So just remind yourself that you, when these good things start pouring in, it's not just because life happens to you. Like, you have taken the initiative to get past all these things to get to these things. And that you deserve them. Like, you have worked for them. You have worked to raise the vibration of your lifestyle to create conditions to invite more positivity in. That is, you did that. So this is going to be just a big shift for you. I'm seeing this with this Two of Air, this kind of crossroads energy. It's going to feel like night and day when it happens. Like, wow, I met nice people. That never happens to me. And this also, similarly to the eight of feathers, that it's just getting rid of that block is going to open you up to not just more, like, physical stability, but also you're just going to be so much more in tune with your emotions and your intuition. And that's probably something which, obviously, all of us, but that's, I'm just feeling that that's something you've been wanting. You've been, like, feeling like, sorry, I burped. Like, why am I so, I don't know, I just feel closed off from my emotions. Or maybe you haven't even noticed it because you've been so shut off from your emotions. You feel kind of numb. So when this change happens, that's going to be, like, this big thing you notice, is that you're either feeling your emotions are more actually existent, or you're just going to feel them on a whole different level. It's just going to be, like, amped up from here to, ooh, way up there. That was embarrassing. Yeah, so this is going to be a good time for you to work on your intuition if that's something that you are interested in, because removing these blocks and creating better, a better, like, life conditions for yourself is going to open you up to feel more comfortable and safe to start using those gifts. So moving on to the oracles, we have protection. So cover up the words again. We have protection. So during all this, similarly to this four of feathers, this card of rest and rejuvenation, and then the star, peace and healing, it's more or less going to be an internal battle for you to get to these better things. So you might end up feeling like you're just like in a cocoon for, you know, a few days, a few weeks, just like getting all this straightened out, all this figured out. But just remember that that's fine. Like, sometimes that's what you need. Like, protect yourself while you're doing all this. You know, if you need to shut off your phone for a day and sit under the blankets and, you know, sit in your room and meditate all day, that's fine sometimes, okay? And then we see this end of an era. Like, if you do all these things, this is truly going to be like, these things left in the past. You are not blocking yourself off emotionally and mentally anymore. You are moving on to a new chapter, finally. I'm just feeling this sigh of relief again. Like, you're probably thinking, oh, thank goodness, finally, and that you're with Rhiannon Sorceress. You are a powerful manifester. You can do this. You just have to just will these conditions into existence, because the blocks for you are internal, so the unblocking is internal. You can do it yourself. Spirit Fox, trust your talents in changing times. So first of all, changing times, they are. Trust yourself. Trust your ability to with this manifestation. You are probably someone who's a really, really good manifester. You speak things, write things, think things into existence. And that's something with these, picking up all the cards, for this Queen of Water here, that's something that these changes are going to open up for you. And then with this Alpha Dragon, okay, so yeah, definitely with all of these things coming together, Alpha Dragon, harness the divine masculine power of creation, destroy the old, visualize your dream, help to manifest a new world. Okay, and then with the Fire Dragon, sorry, I didn't show you the Alpha Dragon again. And then we have the lovely Fire Dragon right here. Burns up the lower energies around you. You are safe and protected. Be determined and inspired. Clear your soul pathway. So that is a nice way to close this out. Just as overall, this is the energy of out with the old, in with the new, and that these energies that are coming in right now from yourself and from outside sources, this is just what the universe is giving to you right now. Like, it is time for you to burn up, burn them up, those old energies, to invite in these new conditions that you deserve, that it is time for you to have them. It is time for this, like, divine creation of a new, just a life that feels like completely like a 180 turnaround. How could this be my life? But you deserve it. Okay, so that's what I have for group two. I'm going to move on to group three. Okay, so those of you who chose group three with this nice big piece of amethyst, we are going to start with the tarot cards and then move on to the oracle. Wonderful. Okay, so first we have strength. Beautiful elephant. We have the 10 of feathers. We have the 8 of shells. We have the 7 of acorns. That's funny, because that's another deck got that same card. We have the Tower. What fun this October we are having. We have the 5 of Water. We have the 3 of Water. We have the Hermit. Okay. Again, I'm seeing that a few of you probably picked several decks or a couple decks and are seeing similarities that you resonate with. We have the Page of Fire. Oh dear, and we have the Ten of Air. So we have two of the same card here, this Ten of Feathers and the Ten of Air. Same, the tarot decks just have different suits. Okay, moving on to the Oracle, we have the Burdock Tenacity. Woo! Yeah, this is already making sense. This is a pretty clear one. Okay, we have Finances. I'm sure that resonates pretty strongly with some of you. We have Mary Magdalene, Unconditional Love. Beautiful. We have a Lord here, Take Charge with Authority. Aw. Sorry, I really like pink. And you have the Magenta Dragon. High key jealous. And the Silver Lunar Dragon. Okay. Coming through group three. I am high key jealous of this group. Okay, so first of all, right off the bat, the thing that I'm noticing most is that this repetition of the Ten of Feathers, Ten of Air, which correlates to Ten of Swords and the traditional suits, and this tower. So I am seeing that for you, depending on who you are, what resonates with you, that this Ten of Feathers energy, which traditionally is someone being stabbed in the back on the ground with 10 swords, this is something that you're coming out of and you're like, okay, how do I come out of this in October? How do I grow from this through October? Or this is something that you're going to need to keep an eye out for coming in October. Like, you know, don't be afraid of the future, but just be prepared that sometimes uncomfortable things happen because that is how we grow. It's like stick it in the crucible, stick it in the oven, bake it at 350, it's hot, but it comes out a new product. That was a weird metaphor, but hopefully you understand that. Yeah, so whether this is something you are watching this and you're like, I know exactly what you're talking about, and it was terrible, and I feel like, you know what, or you're keeping an eye out for it. I'm seeing this Strength card. This isn't like, oh, honey, hopefully you can get through it. This is, you are presented with these things that are honestly quite uncomfortable, probably very, very difficult. Probably a lot of tears is what I'm feeling. Because you need to realize your strength. You need to realize that you are someone who has so much endurance, and you've probably already endured a lot, but what I'm feeling from a lot of you is probably that it's not always fun to hear. But sometimes when a lot of bad things happen to us, we like to get into victim mentality and feel like, oh, I'm just a victim. Poor me. I'm so weak. Like, bad things just happen to me. And then you kind of want people to, like, coddle you and just come and say, oh, honey, it's okay. And just let someone else put a band-aid on it. Well, this October energy for you is realize your own strength. You don't need other people to come in and save you. And with this Eight of Shells, this renewal, and I'm seeing this as walking away from old things that don't serve you, and with this Seven of Acorns, determination and stamina, is just, you know, keep remembering that you are being presented with these difficult things because you have the strength to move away right now. Like, you are strong enough now to move away from old ways that may have been what you needed. Like, maybe in the past you weren't strong enough to deal with it by yourself, but now you are. You can deal with this by yourself. You can go through these big problems, and you don't need to, like, you know, phone in a friend to come fix it. I mean, you can still have a support system, but you will know that you have the power to do this yourself. And that's what you're moving towards, from that old habit to this new habit of like self dependency, whatever that word is. And that's just going to be the thing you need to stick it out with this whole month, is just remembering your own strength, even when it's hard. Know that you're not being presented with things that you can't handle. That's why you're being presented with them, because you can not only handle them, but you can come out stronger on the other end. You can come out more confident. And that confidence keeps popping in my head as something that, that's something that you really, really want. You want to be really grounded in that confidence. And that's what, if you stick it out through this, that's what you're going to come out of this with in October. Yeah, and with this five of water, you know, always easier said than done, but it's going to be important for you to remember when it gets emotionally heavy to shift your focus to that bigger picture. I mean, let yourself feel your emotions. They're valid and they guide you, but don't get stuck in them and just get back into that victim mentality. Remember that this is something to grow from. When these hard emotions hit you, focus on the fact that you are faced with challenges because you are so strong that you can come out of those challenges stronger. And you know what I'm seeing is that you are going to have you're going to have ways of having fun during all this. I mean, October is going to be a fun month for you as well. Whether that's this three of water energy, whether if that's just you and you like to have fun, like dancing alone in your room or something, maybe that's something that you could benefit from doing more this month, you know, for some emotional relief from this heavy stuff. But I'm also seeing that for a lot of you, you're going to have friends who are there to kind of help lift the weights off sometimes. Like if you want to go out on the weekends, or if you want someone to come over and just like sip tea with you, cool, have fun doing that. But I'm also seeing this hermit card here, so it's probably going to be a little of both. You know, sometimes you're going to want other people, you know, to, you know, sometimes you need a little crutch, sometimes you need to cry on someone else's shoulder instead of just in your blankets. And that's totally fine. You know, you can still be a strong person and need support sometimes. But I'm seeing that also, probably a lot of the time, you're going to want to deal with this alone. And that is fine. It doesn't mean you're a hermit in a negative sense. It just means you need alone time this month. And people need to respect that, honestly. People need to respect your boundary and what you are going through. Yeah, and then this page of fire, that's an interesting one to throw in here. I'm just seeing this, if you've been feeling creatively blocked because you feel so stuck, I'm just seeing like a new, some good news coming in this month, or some new, a feeling of like renewed passion. If it's news, it might come from someone who's like younger than you or has like really youthful energy. Someone who's like really fiery energy, like someone you describe as spunky. Or just something that gets you excited. You know, you're not just, this isn't just a month for you to like fend off bad emotions. You know, there's good stuff. There's good stuff with this three of water. You're going to have fun. And with this page of fire, you're going to feel hot, fiery passion, whatever that means for you. Not going to get too in-depth with that, but do with that what you will. Yeah, and this tenacity, this is going back to that strength. It's not just this, you know, bearing burden strength. It's literally the word tenacity. Like you're, again, I use the word spunky again, but like you can be spunky. You can be like, oh, I can do this. You know, I'm excited to get past these things. And then sometimes you go back into hermit mode. Both sides of that are fair. Then we have finances, and this is just for some of you. I feel that when you go through rough things, you might have a tendency to spend a lot of money. Like, you're an emotional spender. And that might be part of this whole test here for some of you, is finding better coping mechanisms. I mean, you know, retail therapy is fun sometimes. I am known to go out and buy iced coffee when I'm sad. But, you know, maybe don't buy a new car every time someone calls you a name. You know, find this happy medium. Move from the old energies to better energies. I think that's just for some of you. For others of you, this shift, finding this inner strength, might be opening you up. Like, this new confidence might be opening you up to more opportunities that bring in a better financial situation for you. But since this is a general reading, you'll get multiple meanings for literally the same card. And so with Mary Magdalene, unconditional love, love yourself and others and every situation, no matter what the outward appearances may be. So that's interesting. I'm seeing that I don't like the word lack, but this lack of confidence might have in your past manifested as you taking it out on other people who might be confident, and that might be part of this learning process for you, is learning what confidence feels like, and in turn also learning to be happy for people who are confident instead of, this is just some of you, I don't want you to feel like I'm attacking you, but you might have a tendency to be jealous of people who are like happy. You might have a tendency to see someone who's confident in their life, confident in their abilities, their appearance, their attitude, and be like, he's cocky, she's cocky, they're cocky. Which some people are cocky, but some people are just confident. And confidence is a wonderful thing to have. So that is another side of this for you. Along with that internal self-love that's coming with all of this too, that's going to help you get through all of this. And this Lord card, take charge with authority. That's just this energy with the strength, the tenacity, and the Lord card authority, really taking charge of it. Not just, you know, all this change is not going to happen if you just take the blows and cry, or, you know, bad things happen and you just hide and don't actually deal with any of it and think, well, I've been through the hard things, where's the change? Well, you have to learn and grow from the hard times. That's how the change comes, and that's how you improve and things get better for next time. Taking this initiative. So with this magenta dragon, enables you to bring forward your soul wisdom. And the silver lunar dragon bathes you in divine feminine light. So I'm seeing this silver lunar dragon being connected with this Mary Magdalene card, with divine feminine light, this energy of love, come into balance and practice peace, harmony, and cooperation. Peace, harmony, and cooperation. So those are not only peace, harmony, and cooperation with other people, but within yourself, and that's what's going to manifest. You might be feeling like there's some rifts in your social life. Things aren't super harmonious and that people are like a little iffy around you. And it's just your internal struggle manifesting into your life. Once you get this straightened out with this magenta dragon, enabling you to bring forward your soul wisdom, I think for you, this is just, what I'm really feeling is getting back to how you know you are. You know, you might feel like you don't have confidence, but deep down, you have confidence and you know it. So that's what you're getting back to, is this deeper inner wisdom, like coming out again, manifesting in your life, knowing how good things can be and letting yourself have it. This very creative energy, like you are taking back control. Once you harness this confidence and this authority, you can really let your love and creativity flow. So that is all I'm seeing for group three, and I'm going to move on to group number four. Ooh, I dropped a card. Tenacity. What fun. Okay, so for those of you who chose group four with the yellow citrine that sort of matches my shirt, we're going to start with the tarot and then move on to the oracle. So we have the six of shells, which I will clarify did fly out of the deck for you. We have the ace of shells. Okay, we have the five of shells. Shelly. Straight man. We have the ace of crystals. Okay, so already two aces. Guys are in for some fun. We have the three of feathers, which we saw the three of air in another deck. We have the four of earth, and a lot of similarities between you guys. We have the eight of fire. We have the page of water. King of air. And ten of water. Moving on to the oracle, we have Ghost Pipe Mystery. Okay, that's a funny name for a plant, but mystery is the takeaway. Hobbies from the butterflies. We have Guinevere, True Love. Okay, spicy. We have Traveler, Move in a New Direction. Okay. A lot of different things here. We have the golden crested dragon. And we have Archangel Gabriel's dragon. Okay. So starting with the tarot, already what I'm seeing here is these two cards right here next to each other, the three of feathers and the four of earth, is that, and with this five of shells as well, as I'm seeing that there's this lack of harmony and balance that's been hurting you. This probably keeps happening. You'll notice that things in your life start to feel out of whack, and then they're like, not so much explode, but I'm feeling this like implosive energy. When you feel down, you probably feel like your whole world has just imploded and disintegrated. What I'm seeing for you in October, though, is this, with the six of shells, sentiment and joy. Okay, that's some beautiful energy right there. And with the ace of shells, which is just emotional gifts, so much abundance, happiness, joy, and this ace of crystals too, like two aces, manifestation, prosperity. I'm seeing you moving away from this fixation on stability, so much so that it's toxic, and finding a way to focus on a healthy way to view stability, like actually finding balance. And I'm seeing that in this October, sorry, I'm like resting on my hand. This is gonna come pretty quickly for you. Honestly, if you're watching it before October even starts, you might start your October already having made these improvements. And that's just what you're coming in with, that energy. If not, this is something that once you start to decide you want to make these changes, it's going to be a pretty quick, easy change from you. But overall, I'm seeing that in the past, you might have had this fixation on the negative, and that fixation on the negative made you want to go completely in the opposite direction and just like control literally everything around you and maybe even everyone around you. I feel like that might resonate with some of you guys, especially with this King of Air energy. I feel like a lot of you really have this. You might be an air sign, you might have a lot of air sign in your chart, or you might just have that energy. You're someone who, like, even if sometimes you might pretend like you don't know what you want, like, you know what you want. You are someone who, like, absolutely knows in their head what they want. But sometimes that manifests as you being super stubborn and not seeing. I'm seeing this, what's coming for you in October with this Page of Water and also the Ten of Water. And the Ace of Shells. Wow, you guys, this is a really fun one. There's a lot of emotional gifts coming in for you in October. Accept them. You might feel like, oh, this is new stuff. I don't know. Like, I like to stick to my old stuff. But with this Five of Shells and the Four of Earth, I'm seeing that the lesson for you is letting go of that. Like, it's good to know what you want. Okay, it's good to be like that kind of energy. Like, you know, this is what I want. I'm gonna get it. I want it. I got it. But it's time to like get in touch with your emotional side and honestly your softer side. I'm seeing that a lot of people might see some of you as kind of like rigid, like this sword energy, like don't get close to me, like I'm strong, but don't touch me. And so people keep it about a sword's length away from you at any given time. Yeah, so the real thing for you, which it's totally a good thing, it might be hard for you because of this like fixation energy, this stubbornness energy. But I mean, a lot of you might not even be that stubborn. It's just something that you could improve on. Okay, I'm not trying to say that you don't change at all. Although some of you might think, yeah, that's me and I'm afraid of change. There's just a lot of good, like maybe friendships. Just like I'm feeling this like bubbly, happy energy. Maybe that's a person. Maybe this Page of Water is someone who just comes in with this very youthful, bubbly, emotional energy. And they're a gift. This person is a gift, and or this situation or these gifts that come in that are more abstract, these are gifts for you to accept. And it's interesting because for you the challenge is learning to accept what's being given to you. Like I'm seeing that for this group, beautiful things and both emotional prosperity and like physical prosperity, like abundance, maybe even like money, good situations, good jobs, good opportunities, just like comfort and stability. The universe has been trying to throw them your way and you're like so fixated on this like control that you're not seeing. It's like you're looking like right over there and like everything's right here. And you're like, oh my God, why am I not getting everything I've dreamed of? And it's like right by your ear. Okay, so it's time to like let it happen. Like recognize, start to learn to recognize these things that are just like literally like I'm just like seeing them pouring like out of a jar, like on your head in a good way. Like it's beautiful. It's just coming in. Like, yeah, October for you can be just, like, the best time if you just let it be that way. Like, even though it might feel different, Embrace the difference, embrace the change, because it's going to be really good for you. It's going to be really good for your emotional well-being and your emotional development. Yeah, with this mystery card here, for some of you, it might feel scary, you know, change might feel scary, but it's about embracing this mystery. You know, everyone is different, and it's like, why are we surrounded by all these different people if we're not supposed to learn to at least accept differences, different ways of seeing things? And especially for a lot of you with this Page of Water, I'm feeling that someone is going to come in who just deals with things very differently than you, and you're going to have to learn to find the beauty in that. And if you do, it's just going to make your whole month, I mean, they might stick around for longer than a month, or this might be a more abstract thing. And once you learn to accept it and see the beauty in it, it's just going to bring so much more, like the spectrum of your emotions is just going to be amped up. Okay, and we have hobbies here. Maybe there's something that you've been thinking, I want to do, but I'm not supposed to do that. Like, I'm supposed to do these things. I don't have time for that. Well, October is the time for you to pick those things back up and just let yourself have some fun. This is fun. And then next to this true love card, okay, like maybe this is just for some of you, but I'm like feeling a lot from it. So get out there. The romantic stirrings in your heart have propelled the universe to deliver great love to you. And honestly, since this is next to, I'm seeing it now. So on one side here, we have hobbies. And then on the other side here of this Guinevere card, we have traveler, move in a new direction. So for some of you, what I'm seeing, and maybe some of you are going to get both of the things I'm about to say, but for some of you, what I'm seeing is just this really big spark of not just like, yay, like I love this, but like really loving something, like picking up this hobby, or maybe something that you still do that used to be a hobby. Like maybe you're a crafter, an artist, I don't know, maybe you do readings and then you kind of fell out of love with it. Something that really, like, I'm feeling like a deep love, like a really deep, mature, understanding, mutual love, feeling like you love your hobby and your hobby loves you, and you just like get so much out of this. This is something to bring back in. But then for some of you, next to this traveler card, I'm seeing that someone just like kind of out of nowhere, who's probably a little bit like wispy, kind of seems to come out of nowhere. Might be a Sagittarius, but I'm super biased because of this traveler energy. Someone might come through that you just have this really deep connection with, and especially with this like Page of Water here, like maybe it's a water sign. You're not all the same, so different people will come in, obviously. Not all gonna date the same person. This really just has to do with like this overall bigger concept of kind of like rolling with it, with this water energy. Like, okay, can you go with the flow for a minute? Because you're used to that like sword energy. Just you're used to being less fluid with this Four of Earth and this Three of Feathers and the King of Air. Being very like more or less in one spot in your comfort zone, in your safe little box. Okay, I'm seeing that people or situations or both are just gonna keep like rolling through for you this October, and just enjoy it. Like, even if, you know, some of these things might stick around for longer than October, but even if it's just like a fling, or, you know, you just, there's something that for some reason is just like seasonal only in October, just enjoy it while it's around, you know, like nothing lasts forever anyway. So if something only lasts a month, it can still be beautiful. Like, still find the beauty and the passion and the love in it. Enjoy it. And then if it has to be let go, let it go. And I feel like that for you might be the hardest part. Accepting these new, more abstract, more fluid things might be hard for you because you're afraid that you might have to let them go sometime. And that might be why, oh my heart, that hurts. So probably some of you are feeling that too. Yeah, that might be part of why you don't open up to new things and people. But we have the golden crested dragon. Brings you higher love so that you can embody divine light. Okay, so yeah, like love, whether it's with like something you're passionate about or a person, something that you can be totally excited about, at least for this month, is like coming for you. Like, brace yourself in a good way. Like, so many good things are coming for you, and I'm like kind of jealous because it's like your challenge is just like accepting good things. It's like, oh, I know it's easier said than done, but it's like so beautiful. And then Archangel Gabriel's dragon brings purification. So this, all this like fun stuff and all these gifts are really going to help you. I'm feeling this like loosening up energy for a lot of you. It's just like, God, like all these cards, it's just like, accept the fluidity of life, accept that things change, accept that people are different than you, and learn to like roll with it. So you can, instead of just having this like one color of life, you can have this whole like rainbow of things going on in your life, and even like past that, like colors you could not even imagine. That's what I'm seeing, like, especially with this traveler and this page of water. It's going to be something that's like as if you just saw a new color for the first time. You're like, I've never seen that. And your first reaction might be like, that's weird. But see the beauty in it. It's something completely new, something completely beautiful. Yeah. So that's what I have for group four. So I'm going to move on to my special thing that I said I would do at the end. It's just a little announcement that involves like Halloween. Because I love Halloween. I don't know if you can see my crooked decorations in the back. It just says Happy Halloween. Promise I'm not decorating yet. Done decorating. So we have this fun pumpkin right here. And what I'm going to do is between now and whatever today's date is and whatever next Sunday's date is, all you have to do is subscribe to me. Or if you're already subscribed, just let me know. But either way, subscribe to me and comment under this video. Or if you're already subscribed, just comment under this video. I'm already subscribed. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put your name in this happy little pumpkin, which is like, you know, we're like twins. And then next Sunday, I'm going to pick out a name from it. And that person is going to get a 30-minute video or call reading, like whichever your preference is. I don't know, some people don't like video, or if you don't even want me to hear your voice for some reason, like you can do it over email, whatever you're comfortable with. And yeah, on that note, also in my description now, if you do want a personal reading, I have updated my, I'll get the pumpkin out of the way, my email for readings is rtwquinn@gmail.com. It's in my like bigger description for my page now. So yeah, let me know if you want a personal reading, or if you just want more info, or you want to know my rates or whatever, or if you just have questions, you can email me. Like, I don't care. I'll answer them. I'm bored. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed today's reading for October. I hope that resonated with some people. I hope you enjoyed it. Or even if it's uncomfortable, you can see how you can grow from it. That's always what to bring out from the uncomfortable things. Yeah, any questions, comments, blah, blah, blah. If it resonated with you, just let me know below in the comments. And I will see you next time.